This is the topic 4, we will learn about, the use of measuring instruments. Accuracy, consistency, sensitivity, and errors.
这是主题 4, 我们将学习测量仪器的使用。 准确性, 一致性, 敏感性和错误性。
During a measuring act, an appropriate measuring instrument. And use it in the correct way is necessary to get a consistent and accurate reading. What is the consistency and accuracy?
在测量过程中, 使用合适的测量仪器, 并以正确的方式使用它, 以获得一致, 且准确的数值是必不可少的。 什么是一致性和准确性呢? 或在中文中, 一致性也可称为精确性。 精确性和准确性通常会被直接被提起为精准度。
There are three important capabilities of a measurement system.
测量系统有三个重要能力。
The first is, consistency.
第一是一致性或精确性。
The second is, accuracy.
第二是准确性。
The third is, sensitivity.
第三是敏感性。
We first talk about the consistency. Consistency is how well a measurement tool to come out the same reading. When the measurement to the same object is conducted repeatedly. Here is an example. An archer performed the shooting to the arrow target repeatedly. If the arrows can shot to about the same location on the target, we say the archer is high consistency. Same to a measurement system. For example, if we repeatedly perform a measurement of a length, by using a ruler, let's say, 5 times, and we able to get the about the same value, through the 5 measurement, we can say, it is good in consistency. If the reading, from one to another have a big variation, we can say it is inconsistent.
我们先谈谈一致性或精确性。测量系统的一致性是 当五对同一物体进行测量时，它是否可得到相同的测量指数？ 举一个例子，弓箭手反复地向箭靶射击， 如果箭头射到目标上的位置大致相同， 我们可以说弓箭手的一致性或精确性是高的，与测量系统相同。 例如，如果我们反复使用标尺进行长度测量， 假设5次, 如果我们这5次的测量值是大约相同的, 那我们可以说它的一致性或精确性很好。 如果从一个到另一个的读数有很大的差异, 我们可以说它是不一致的或是不精确的。
Another example about the consistency is, let's say in a classroom, there are two students who going to take same mathematics exam. In January, Jason gains 75% mark, and Jackie gains 85% mark. In February exam, Jason gains 95% mark, and Jackie gains 84% mark. In March exam, Jason gains 80% mark, and Jackie gains 85%. In April exam, Jason gains 82% mark, and Jackie gains 84%. In May exam, Jason gains 100% mark, and Jackie gains 85%. Throughout the 5 months exam, we can say that Jackie is more consistent in the math exam. As Jackie able to repeatedly come out the same result at 84% to 85%.
关于一致性或精确性的另一个例子是， 假设在教室里有2个学生， 他们每月都要参加不同的数学考试。 1月份, 杰森得75分, 杰基得85分。 在2月份的考试中, 杰森得95分, 而杰基得了84分。 在3月份的考试中, 杰森得80分, 而杰基得85分。 在4月份的考试中, 杰森得82分, 而杰基得84分。 在5月份的考试中, 杰森得100分, 而杰基获得85分的成绩。 在整5个月的考试中, 我们可以说杰基在数学考试中更加一致，因为杰基能够以 84% 到 85% 的分数之间反复得出相近的结果。
The second important capability for a measurement system is accuracy. Accuracy is how close the measured value to the actual value or target value of a physical quantity. Here is an example. An archer performed the shooting to an arrow target repeatedly. Since the target of the shooting is the center of the target board, the more the arrow shoot at the point closer to the center, we can say that it is accurate. For a measurement system, let's say, we have an object with known length. Let's say, it is 5 centimeters. If we repeatedly perform the measurement for 5 times, and we able to get 5 centimeters for each time we do the measurement, we can say that the measurement system is accurate and consistent. Please take note, as all the reading from the 5 measurement are about the same. We also can say that it is consistent to produce the same value too. If the value we get is 6 centimeters for all the 5 measurement, it will be inaccurate. But, please take note here, the system able to reproduce the same value. We can say it is a consistent measurement system.
测量系统的第二重要能力是准确度。准确度是指测量值与物理量的实际值之间的接近程度。这是一个例子。弓箭手反复向箭靶射击。由于射击的目标是箭靶的中心，箭头的击中点越靠近箭靶的中心，我们就可以说它是准确的。对于测量系统，假设我们有一个长度已知的对象，假设它是5厘米。如果我们重复执行5次测量，每次进行测量时，我们可以得到5厘米。我们可以说测量系统是准确的。请注意，因为5次测量的所有读数大致相同，我们也可以说它的一致性或精确性。如果对于所有的5个测量，我们得到的值为6厘米，这将是不准确的。但请注意，因为这系统能够复制相同的值，我们可以说这是一个一致性很好的测量系统。
Let's use the example of the math exam again. Since the exam target is 100% mark, by taking the average of 5 exams, Jason has 88% mark and Jackie has 84.6% mark. Jason's performance is closer to 100% mark. We can say that Jason is more accurate in math exam.
让我们以数学考试为例。由于考试目标是100分，通过得出5次考试的平均分，杰森有88分，杰基有 84.6 分，简接近 100%。 我们可以说杰森在数学考试中更加准确。
The third capability of the measurement system is sensitivity. This is about how small the physical quantity can be measured.
测量系统的第三个功能是灵敏度。这是关于可以测量多少的物理量。
Here is an example. Two archers, let's say Archer A and Archer B, are performing shooting, at which the target board are placed at position 1, where the position 1 is at a distance closer to the archers. The arrow from both Archer A and Archer B can reach the target board.
这是一个例子。假设有两个弓箭手，弓箭手 A 和弓箭手 B 正在射击，箭靶放置在位置一处，位置一距离弓箭手更近，弓箭手 A 和弓箭手 B 的箭头都可以射击到箭靶。
But when the target board was brought to position 2, which is farther from Archer A and B, and only the arrow from Archer A is capable to shot the target board, we can say Archer A is more sensitive in archery compared with Archer B.
但是箭靶被放置到离弓箭手 A 和 B 更远的位置20，并且 只有弓箭手 A 的箭头才能够射击到箭靶。我们可以说，射手 A 在射箭方面比射手 B 更敏感。
Form measurement system. Ruler A, the smallest quantity for the measurement is 0.1 millimeters. Hence, the sensitivity of ruler A is 0.1 millimeters. For ruler B, the smallest quantity that can be measured is 0.5 millimeters. Hence, its sensitivity is 0.5 millimeters. For the ruler C, the smallest quantity that can be measured is 1 millimeter. Hence, its sensitivity is 1 millimeter. Since ruler A can measure the smallest quantity, 0.1 millimeters, we can say, ruler A is a sensitive ruler, compared to the rest of the two.
用于测量系统。标尺 A 最小测量量为 0.1 毫米。因此，标尺 A 的灵敏度为 0.1 毫米。对于标尺 B, 最小可测量量为 0.5 毫米。因此其灵敏度为 0.5 毫米。对于标尺 C, 最小测量量为 1 毫米。因此其灵敏度为 1 毫米。由于标尺 A 可以测量的最小量值为 0.1 毫米。我们可以说，与其他两个标尺相比，标尺 A 是最敏感的标尺。
This is the new topic, using the right measuring instrument.
这是新主题，使用正确的测量仪器。
Different physical quantity is measured, using different measuring instrument.
使用不同的测量仪器来测量不同的物理量。
The examples of physical quantity for measurement to be discussed here is as following.
此处讨论的测量物理量事例如下。
They are, length.
它们是长度
volume
体积
mass
质量
time
时间
temperature
温度
an electrical current
核电流
how these physical quantity from an object or phenomena being measured by using a right instrumentwill be detailed in the coming part of the lesson.
来自物体或现象的物理量如何使用正确的工具被测量将在本课程的下一部分被详细介绍。
We first talk about length.
我们先谈论长度。
Length is defined as the distance between two points. These two points can be happened in any physical objects or places.
长度被定义为两个点之间的距离。这两个点可以在任何物理物体或地方发生。
The SI unit for physical quantity, length, is meter, with symbol m. About its application, cm and m is used to measure shorter distances. km is used to measure the longer distances.
物理量长度的 SI 单位为米，符号为 m.关于其应用 ,cm 和 m 用于测量较短的距离 ,km 用于测量更长的距离。
Here is some example about the unit conversion, for the meter in it, between different prefix. 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 m. At which, k, kilo, is represent 1000. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters.1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeters.
这里有不同前缀，以 SI 单位表示米的单位转换的一些事例。一公里等于一千米。在此 ,K, kilo, 代表一千。一米等于一百厘米。一厘米等于十毫米。
The example of measurement instrument are meter rule, and measuring tape.
测量仪器的示例为米尺和卷尺。
About volume.
关于体积。
Volume is defined as the amount of space occupied by an object.
体积被定义为对象占用的。
The SI unit for volume is cubic meter, it is meter power of 3. Why it is a power of 3? Because the volume have occupied the space, which is formed from 3-dimension length, at which, they are perpendicular from each other's.
体积的SI单位是立方米, 它是米的三次方。 为什么它是米的三次方呢? 因为体积占据由三维长度形成的空间。 在此, 这三个维度它们是彼此垂直的。
About its application. Cubic millimeter, cubic centimeter, milliliter, and liter are used to measure the volume of a liquid. For your knowledge, 1 cubic millimeter is equal to 1 millimeter in x direction, multiplied with 1 millimeter in y direction, multiplied with 1 millimeter in z direction. 1 cubic centimeter is in centimeter in x direction, multiplied with 1 centimeter in y direction, multiplied with 1 centimeter in z direction. The cubic is pointed to both the prefix and the unit.
关于其应用, mm 毫米的三次方, cm 厘米的三次方, mL 毫升, 和 L 公升, 用于测量液体的体积。 您必须知道的事项是, 一毫米的三次方, 等于x 方向的一毫米, 乘y 方向的一毫米, 乘z 方向的一毫米。 一厘米的三次方, 等于x 方向的一厘米, 乘y 方向的一厘米, 乘z 方向的一厘米。 立方, 或三次方, 同时指向, 前缀和单位。
About the unit conversion, 1 cubic centimeter is equal value to 1 milliliter. 1 liter is equal value to 1000 milliliter, or 1000 cubic meter. 1 cubic meter is equal value to 1 million cubic meter, or 1 million milliliter.
关于单位的换算, 一立方厘米, cm 的三次方, 相等, 一毫升。 一公升, 相等于 1000毫升 ml, 或 1000立方厘米的值。 一立方米等于 100万立方厘米, 或 100万毫升。
Measuring cylinder, is the example of instrument, used to measure volume of a liquid.
量筒, 是用于测量液体体积的仪器的示例。
This is about the mass of objects.
这是关于物体的质量。
Mass of an object, is defined as the quantity of matter of the object.
物体的质量被定义为物体的物质量。
The SI unit for mass is kilogram, and denoted by symbol kg.
质量的国际单位为千克号 kg 来表示。
For application, unit kilogram and gram are used to measure the mass of objects.
对于应用，单位千克和克。 用于测量物体的质量。
This is about the unit conversion, between the prefixes of the unit.
这是关于单位前缀之间的单位转换。
1 kilogram is equal value to 1000 gram.
1公斤等于1000克。
1 gram is equal value to 1000 milligram.
1克等于1000毫克。
Triple beam balance, is the measurement instrument, used to measure the mass of an object.
三量平衡, 是用于测量物体质量的测量仪器。
This is about the physical quantity, time.
这是关于物理量, 时间。
The physical quantity, time, is the measured period between.
时间, 是两个时刻之间的量测时间。
The SI unit for the time is, second, and which denoted by symbol, S.
时间的SI单位为秒, 并用符号S来表示。
For application, the unit, seconds, minutes, hours, days, months, and years, are used for time measurement.
对于应用,单位为秒, 分钟, 小时, 天, 月, 年。
This is about the unit conversion between the time units. 1 day is equal value to 24 hours. 1 hour is equal value to 60 minutes. 1 minute equal value to 60 seconds.
这是关于时间单位之间的单位转换。 一天等于24小时。 一小时等于60分钟。 一分钟60秒。
Stopwatch, is the example of measurement instrument, used for time measurement.
秒表是用于时间测量的测量仪器示例。
This is about the physical quantity, temperature.
这是关于物理量，温度。
About the definition, temperature is the physical quantity used to measure of how hot an object is.
关于定义，温度是用于测量物体温度的物理量，就是测量它有多热。
The SI unit that used for temperature measurement is Kelvin.
用于温度测量的 SI 单位是开尔文。
For application, Kelvin and Celsius are the units used to measure temperature of objects.
对于应用，开尔文和摄氏度是用于测量物体温度的单位。
For the unit conversion between us and Kelvin, 1 degree Celsius equal value to 274.15 K. So 1 Kelvin equal value to 1 divided by 274.15 degrees Celsius.
对于摄氏和开尔文之间的单位转换。一摄氏度相等于 274.15 开尔文。所以一开尔文等于一除于 274.15 摄氏度。
Thermometer are the instrument used to measure the temperature of an object.
温度计是用于测量物体温度的仪器。
About physical quantity, electrical current.
关于物理量，电流。
Electrical current is defined as the rate of flow of the charges through a conductor. When you see the word rate, it means it is related to time. Rate of flow meant to how many charges flow through from one point to another. Within a certain time, it is 1 second.
电流被定义为电荷通过导体的流速。当您看到单字“律时”，表示它与时间相关。流量是指从一个点到另一个点流过导体的电荷量。在一定时间内是一秒。
The SI unit for electrical current is ampere, and it is denoted by symbol A.
电流的 SI 单位是安培，并用符号 A 来表示。
Unit ampere and milliampere are used in the electrical current measurement.
在电流测量中，单位安培和毫安被使用。
1 ampere is equal value to 1000 milliampere. 1 milliampere is equal value to 0.001 ampere.
1 ampere 等于1000毫安。1毫于 0.001 ampere.
Ammeter is the example of measurement instrument for the current.
电流表是电流测量仪器的示例。